words don't cut me deep. With the knife between your teeth, you just smile and watch me bleed. But this won't take your pain away at all. The higher the wall, the harder you fall. Did you get what you came in for?
How's it going? You're listening to On the Wake Up Radio. It's your host, Simply Ray. And you can find us at On the Wake Up 2 on YouTube or On the Wake Up Radio. How's it going, everybody? Another week, another dollar, as they say, right? Pretty soon. It's going to be another day, another Bitcoin. Oh, my God. Oh, could you imagine? I can. I don't have to imagine. They've shown it to us in movies, books, everything, over and over. Our lives are leading to total waste. With the money that we use, the fake paper money that they print, all the way to the new central fucking bank digital currencies, right? They want to hook you. They got you. if you've ever ordered anything from anything online, you're hooked. They got you. Got you, bitch. We are all hooked, everybody. If you've ordered a trumpet, if you've ordered a croissant, if you've ordered something from Amazon, if you've ordered anything, you name it. They got it. The convenience, right? It used to be the convenience of getting in your car and going downtown and finding that perfect something, right? That handmade, handmade, antique, cool something. And even still back then, I sort of get it now that was like the spell, right? So, there's an episode in Rick and Morty where they sort of talk about this, where you go into the store and you buy something and the guy's like, oh, you don't really pay with money. When you buy this, you're going to be cursed. And the episode didn't make, it made sense when I thought. And I get it. And but that sort of what's going on. You're born into it. You don't even realize it yet. The minute you start using money, you know, you're not really using money. And it doesn't hit you. It doesn't hit you how big the trick is. You know, until you realize you're the Pinocchio and that the island, the whole place is that place that they snuck you off to. And they didn't even need to sneak you off to it anymore. Damn, you're born right into it. Just as long as you don't question where the walls are, where the prison walls are, or how to get out or anything, then you're okay. You're fine. You'll have yourself a grand old time. You will live and die unknowing of what was going on. And some people do. There's some people that pay attention so much, they end up controlling the whole place. Right? And that's scary too. Yeah, that, right? Well, watching these presidential elections has to be the most entertaining thing I think we have. What else is there on TV? What else is there? They put on the news, people blowing up, things blowing up, ratings down. I could put on Survivor. Let's put some people on the island and make them just play some stupid games. Ratings down. Reality TV Gordon Ramsay yelling at people, telling them to shut the fuck up, ratings down. What are people watching? YouTube. And everyone arguing about who's going to be the goddamn president of the United States of America. I can't believe it. Baby Vance graduated high school in 2003. Seems like he's a kid. Someone told me, hey, the guy that's about to take over your company, yeah, he graduated high school in 2003. Oh my God. You got Biden wants to put term limits on the Supreme Court justice, which we all know we need. We need age limits. We need age limits. I mean, I hate to be the one to be mean about it, but 65, whenever retirement is, you're done. You're done. You can't be a senator or a congressman or a assemblyman or a policeman. Nothing. Nothing after 65. Everybody done. You're done. Done. Get off the stage. Leave the stage right. Go sit down. Get in your chair. Get a coffee in your hand. And have some popcorn to watch. Go away. No, but for real. It's a circus every day, right? How can that be? How can it be? You know, you turn the news on, Israel just done went and fucked things up some more. Yeah, war. Right? Oh my God. They didn't, and to attack straight in Iran, right? Like, they just going for it. You didn't just break into someone. You didn't ate all the cookies and, you know, peed in the cookie jar and left. What do you think was going to happen? What do you think about it? Everybody's waiting for it. I sort of thought it happened during COVID, that moment where we all finally say, how many strings are we going to let them pull before everybody gets sorted? And I know, I've heard it. Oh my God, no, that's the end of the world. Not though, it's not going to all happen at once. But little by little, right? Little by little, you know. For some of us, that just takes too long. That's just too long to wait. That's just too long to see it be so, such a lie. Right? I think that's the hardest part about waking up. You realize how big of a lie. Pinocchio, when you wake up, it's like, holy shit. Right? You're in the middle of the circus and you're trying to wake everybody else up and it's just, there's no way. There's no way that's real. There's no way that it's that it would take as long as it would take to fix the mess, right? But that's sort of the point. You realize there is no fixing the mess. And that, quote unquote, you fix yourself, you change the world, right? So you start that little journey up that hill. And you get to that next point where you realize, oh, that was also just another control structure. Because once you're mad about the system, well, here you go, learn how to be people. Because no, being angry about going on with society, that's wrong. You can't be mad. Don't be mad. They'll be peaceful. They're robbing you left and right, but they'll be peaceful. It's hard to see it at different, those different junctures, I guess, right? Haven't really analyzed why all this is cool. It is one big scam and we're just watching a movie. The TV is just fake and it's all just fake and it's just popcorn and nothing's really going on. Well then. Right? Whoa. No way. Whoa. Or if it is real. Is what they put on the TV, is that real? Did Trump really get shot at by some dumb fucking kid? I don't know. I can't take it as real anymore. Even if it is real. Even if it's the whole truth. It looks so fake that it's hard to take it for anything. Lost all legitimacy. There's been so much contradiction and back and forth that nobody's right. The fact that they have to censor every one of us, then that really makes you fucking lose all legitimacy. Now you just have to delete opinions that don't go with what you're saying. My God. Thought we learned about this shit in high school. What the fuck? Who the fuck is in charge? Who the fuck thinks they're in charge? Favorite question. I think you need to be reminded that ain't nobody in charge. Try to be a tyrant. Be a tyrant. Go ahead. Yet everybody's still argues and fights about, oh, my president's going to be better. My corporate choice is going to be better. My big tech executive selection is going to be better than your tech, billionaires. All the same rich people picking the people who they're going to pick. Making us bicker and fight over every little contradiction. That's the point, that you'll see one candidate was on this side about the subject, and then the next time it's going to be on that side about the subject. Back and forth. And they'll be there bouncing back and forth to America. That's the game. How do you keep an idiot busy? Right? We all fall for it. We're all guilty of it. Because, I mean, part of us knows, I mean, this is, I mean, if the ship goes down, we're all going to go with it. So, I think we all watch to that degree of, we can't let the ship go down. Some bullshit happening? All right. As long as the ship's not going down. Good. I'm going to catch some sleep. I'm going to sleep. Hopefully I wake up. If I don't wake up, though, goodbye. Good luck. Good luck. Goodbye to everybody. Good luck. I get it. You kick the can down the road and you go take a nap. Hope that the whole house ain't burning down by the time you wake up. Or that at least you could get out, right? I think that's what I've come to, like, really, really like, liminal spaces and liminal art. Where it's when you're looking at something and you can see you're entering somewhere, but you can't see where the exit is. And you know it once you start seeing these images. You start, it gives you that feeling of like, where am I going to get out? Where do I get out? Where's the exit? Where And so it causes that bit of anxiety. And I know I've described like this feeling where you're in a building and there's bricks on the windows and bricks on the doors. And you're working, everybody's working, and you like look around and you're like, I need to get out of here. And you go and you pull the shades on the windows, and it's just a fake sunlight. It's just the bricks back there. And you go to the next window, some more bricks. You go to the elevator and you push the button, and bam, it's just a brick wall. And then you turn and look, and then there's Cindy Lou, and she's like, what's wrong, Greg? Why don't you get back to work? And you're like, oh my gosh, you don't realize we can't get out of here? And they're like, no, nothing's wrong. Get back to work. Get back to work. Right, there it's that moment. It's that kind of like a no way. And that's like what life is. That's that great big moment in life when you realize, oh, no way. There's only one way out of here. So you go and you sit back down at that desk and you start doing some nothing work. Like, I don't even know what I'm doing here. And you look around and everybody's busy working. I want to be here working. Pull your hair out, scream, and you look up at the camera. But then you realize, well, better being here than being anywhere else, I would say. Right? When they say America is the best country on the face of the earth, I mean, we would have, a lot of us would agree.
Yeah, hell yeah, yeah, woo!
Because if they did, if they started kicking people out, right? Everybody's like, wait a minute, wait a minute, wait a minute, wait a minute. I was just kidding. But I think everybody's waking up to that. That there's no exit moment. Only way out of here is to just go through it. Get through it. And that's gonna be crazy. I mean, everybody speculates what's gonna happen. Win the election or whatever. And, you know, everybody, there's gonna be a big false flag event. Well, yeah, I mean, there has to be. There has to be something to distract you from doing something. Right? It's all they've been doing. Things have to stay this way, right? That's when you realize, wait, what's the fall? This, all of this, everything. That something will happen so that nothing will change. Right? I love that one. That's a good one. Something happens. Something will happen so that nothing changes. We all wonder what would have happened. Right? I think we've seen that Zapruder film, seen Kennedy get popped in the head so many times. All of us just keep wondering, man, what would have happened if Trump did? So ingrained. That's the kind of stuff that makes me feel like, all right, maybe we are on a different. Maybe things can and will be better, right? Where at least they can get away with that anymore. right? Where they're, you know, and that's sort of the thing too, right? It's like, you'll have the mental power to change what's going on. Like how I say we can think our way out of this, think our way out. And it's the same way, like affecting the random number generator. Right? If you're focusing on it, you'll make it happen. Okay. All of us, we've been sitting there watching the TV, and they make this touchdown right here. Oh, this happens. Hope this happens. And it either happens or there's a big lesson. And I think that's sort of like, that was, to me, the first, well, like I see now where you have mass, experiments in consciousness shifting, right? Where everybody wants one team to win, and whoever, whoever had people focusing on one thing would have to get their way that they wanted, right? That's sort of the big trick, the big secret that they don't want to know. The more people focusing on one thing, and they've done a great job at that. Look here, but don't look over here while we do this. And all of a sudden, they got us again. they get us every time, right? And so with Trump and Vance, he's on one side of the fence four, and he's on the other side now. And I think you'll see the same thing, right? Where whoever is going to be next up in the cycle, you know, will be totally against, because how much did everybody hate George Bush, right? Like, hated George Bush. And so you had anybody who was anybody but Bush, right? They just do a great job of whacking that ping pong paddle onto the other side. And now everybody's so ping pong paddled, and it's happened so fast. And that's sort of how they're getting what they want even quicker. Because if anything does change, is the bullshit rules and implementations of things that they want to do, right? Or they trick you into thinking it's progress. But it's just another form of control. I mean, for our own good, it's decentralized. Until they do something to take control of it, to regulate it. And it'll happen. And it'll probably be something like to have coin, you have to have that same amount in cash. If you want to have blankety blank Bitcoin, well, then you have to have it backed up with the same amount of cash. In that case, and then what kind of, how would that change? It would be just the rich people with Bitcoin again. Sort of same thing is happening right now with GameStop and the stock market. How they're betting against companies to get rich off. The story of Quiznos is worth example. works. Oh, it works. I think. Close past 20, 30 years. It's that they come in and buy it up and then force all the franchisees to rent and buy things from certain companies, which they also own. And then the franchisees have been effectively priced. Their profit margin has just got eaten up. Whatever profit they were making, really. And so you had the company that you thought was going to help you make money is now nickeling and diming you. Eating into your profit margin. And then you have California raising the minimum wage, and pretty soon there's going to be nothing. Where all it was Starbucks and Quiznos anyway. Well, now there's no Quiznos. It's just Little Caesar's pizza everywhere, $5 pizzas everywhere. I mean, McDonald's, nobody goes to McDonald's anymore. So weird. I have no idea what anybody's eating anymore. Because before, they would open a place and there'd be a line out the door. Not anymore. Some people say the new generation, they don't like going outside. Well, why? Wonder why, right? So if Oakland is closing up, you have places leaving. No more Denny's. No more Diamond. All the mom and pop stores that got obliterated during COVID. Just the restaurants, basically, no longer there anymore. See now where the older generations of the 90s were like, you're driving, what's going on now? Because, I mean, man, the 70s and 80s must have been bitching. I was too young of a kid and didn't notice what was going on, but man. If there's even half as much freedom as there was back then, as there is now. Because what does anybody do anymore? What does everybody do anymore? Everything's made in other countries. Everybody in America, everybody just went outside and like looked around. Everybody's on their phone. Some people are working. Some people don't do business stuff. But for the most part, everybody's just sitting in their houses, staring at a screen. I don't get it anymore. I really don't. And I don't think anything will change it anytime soon. I don't think there's going to be a restaurant or a food or a family that we'll get everybody out and about socializing or a movie. I think the escapism, right? Inside Out 2, biggest movie ever. What the hell? What the fuck, people? Cartoons? Spending billions to go watch cartoons again. Still. And seeing that fits in perfectly with something happens. So that nothing changes. Right. I mean, people have been watching cartoons in the movies for since they came out a long time. But then we've reached peak wokeness, I would say. Everybody and everything and everywhere. Everybody's woke. Everybody's awake. Everybody's aware. We're all trying. Thank fucking God. We're all finally trying. That is a good thing. It just takes a while, I think. It truly does take the mind a few years to work through certain ideas and to break down certain control structures and thought prisons that we might have thought were real and really aren't. Getting to the end of some of the roads and being like, wait a minute, that was wrong. That's sort of what's happened with anybody who has been following this J.D. Vance guy. And it was like, wait a minute, wasn't he on the other side? Wait a minute. And then until you see who he was aimed at and the viewers. Trying to still keep certain narratives, I guess, at play, right? That's all they're trying to do is keep a certain story going. Then they're the best, that they're right, and that everybody else is okay. On the other side. They're the best, and that what they say is right, and everybody else is wrong. And unless you ever get to exit any of those two episodes, you're not gonna, because you're in them. Most of those people in those echo chambers are in there because they're making money from them. So they're gonna keep repeating, we're the best, we're right, and everybody else is wrong. That's it. That's all it is. Same thing over and over and over and over and over. Well, I guess it is fun to watch and see if Israel, if this is the end of Israel in real time, right? Oh, it's horrible, it's horrible. I shouldn't laugh at that discussion. But, that's sort of what they've gotten. Where, I don't know, how you pick a fight with a few different countries and expect to survive. I don't know. Where you hope everybody in America is awake and aware enough to be like, Israel, you got in a fight. Are you sure you can handle it? Because we're not going to come with you. Right? I mean, is it worth it losing your own kid fighting for someone else's? How many more people are we going to send to the Middle East to fight and die for nothing? Yeah, I'm one of those guys. I'm going to let them turn it to fucking glass. Either both sides set the fuck up or glass. Let's turn that desert into glass. Which I'm pretty sure that's probably what one side does when they get into office. They say, let's just try diplomacy. Bombs or diplomacy, which one do you want? Which side are you going to get? That's America, that's best. But, I mean, if you don't have anybody joining the military, if your numbers are down, reserves are down, then you can't be making the same kind of muscle moves that we used to. I get that, too. Warfare's changed. These drones are actually frightening. I will be the first to say, probably being chased by like 5 or 6, 20 of these drones through the woods, And they all got a grenade on them and they're coming for you. Fuck that. Fuck that. No, thank you. These kids, they know what war is. They've been playing these video games for a while. These motherfucking kids fucking tired of this shit. Where the fuck do you think this stuff came from? God damn it. Fucked up little kids. God damn. So unless you could build, you know, a first-person drone, you know, that's moving at least 100, 120 miles an hour. Shit has changed. No, thank you. Can't hide from a thermal camera. You can, but you know how much work it takes? Nope. We've already lost. We've already lost. And so, yeah, so you've got to ask yourself, my God, Israel, what are you doing? Both sides, my God, they better have some fun. We want to see some fun. I mean, as an American who gets to watch war in real time on the YouTube, let's go. Have some fun clips. Everybody, go boom. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. But you have Trump saying, I'll end the war in a day. I'll come in, it'll be all over. It'll be all over. I'll end it so fast. Nobody's good at ending war like me. I'm the best at ending war. Yeah, right. And then Biden's like, I don't know. It's meant to be like that on both sides. All the time. Which, I mean, it's the very first sentence in The Art of War. War is deceived. If you're deceived, you're good. Stay deceived. But I guess that's why that, you know, the gang tattooed it on his face. The gang. One big gang. Because tomorrow, doesn't matter what happens. We're not going to watch it. Whatever little clip it is, whatever news it is, everybody's like, hey, did you see this? Hey, did you watch that? And some people will be able to comment on it. Other comments will get deleted. I think that's when you gotta wake up. We're being censored to the point where we can't even believe that anything else is real. If none of this is real. If I can't make a comment, well then, believe in anything else. Whatever anybody else says, it's not real. It's not real. Doesn't matter. Doesn't matter what no Supreme Court judge says. Doesn't matter what any comment says. Doesn't matter. It does not matter. Because nothing's real. Our quote unquote inalienable rights. They don't exist. It's not real. If that doesn't exist, if that's not real, well then, motherfucker, nothing else is real then. The earth is flat and fucking Jesus is coming back. I don't know what else to say. Jesus is already back. How about that? Nothing else is real. Nothing's real. Nothing's legitimate. Nothing you say, nothing anybody says. Nah. We're all deaf, dumb, and blind now. That's everybody's gonna play that one. See no evil, hear no evil, speak. It was all for fun and games. All for naught. That's how you guys want to play it. That's the only way you guys can play it. That's that. I think that's it. When you realize, oh, this whole freedom thing is fake. Makes more sense now. Yeah, the whole thing's a scam. It's just a costume and costume and costume. You know somebody that wakes up and puts on a costume? Well, I don't know what to say. Not Halloween. But if none of it's real, then that costume's not real. All of it. None of it. Nothing. It's all for nothing. I mean, but we know it. We know what the truth is. I think that's the hard part. Like I said, you get to that point where you're the dinosaur that's stuck in the electric fences and you start jumping at the fences to see where it's weakest. And when you find those weak spots, hard not to exploit. Yeah. Finally break the fence. Because I know I grew up my whole life and they told us, oh, we've done everything. We've explored everywhere. Blah, 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 blah.
Bring that subject up. No, we don't talk about that. No.
And so the terms and conditions, I love to say.
Will you waive your rights when you hit okay to the terms and conditions?
No, you can't. No, you can't. That's illegal. They can't do that. Them thinking and trying to trick everybody into thinking that you can. I think that's the worst. You can't give up your right. It's like saying you could sell your soul. You can't sell your soul. How are you going to sell it? Who are you going to sell it to? For what price? What machine is going to facilitate that transfer? Well, right? Now we've gotten into the realm of talking about things that don't exist. Well, duh, motherfucker, this whole thing don't exist. So I love that meme where the guy's pumping gas. Like, the Titanic never sank. We don't owe anybody. You're like, oh, shit, that boy, yeah, when that boat sinks, man, when the Federal Reserve sinks, when everybody wakes up so we don't know nothing, wait, that's going to be a day. Because we'll just keep letting it ride. And everybody, today, the debt, the national debt is $111 trillion. Each American owes $1.1 million. Whatever ridiculous number it'll be, but we'll still all be in here. And this will be here. This will be looking at this. Hey, here we all owe $1 million, man. You got that kind of money? Nope. Oh, God, I'm dead over here. I'm dead. That one killed me. That one just gets me. Like, they expect me to care when it says, how much do we owe now? Like, $50,000 each or some shit like that? $30,000? $50,000 for every man, woman, and child of money. And I think that's like sort of like to trick you into thinking you owe some money. Like, you owe some money. So what a great fucking scam, right? Like, Oh, well, the government's like, oh, sure, look, we owe that much. And the government ran that bill up. That's the government's bill. But they're like, they're looking, hey, everybody, look at, if we cut it up between all of us, that's only 10,000 each, only 30,000 each. We're good. You got it. And there you go, everybody. Everybody, you know. So don't allow it. Don't allow it. Don't accept it. Not real. Nothing real. Alright. Let's go ahead and end this week's episode with nothing real. Go ahead and find us at onthewakeupradio.com and on the wake up too on YouTube. Thanks for listening. Over and out.
We are gathered here today into this thing called life.
Flawed individual.
Thanks for keeping the lights on, Deang.
Cindy Ashby Productions.
On the wake up.
Just get your body to move. Won't stop till we shake the room, yeah. Just get your body to move. Why do I need to? Why do I need to? Then on the wake up, hey. Won't stop till they hear what we say, yeah. Then on the wake up, hey. Why do I need to? Why do I need to? Just get your body to move. Won't stop till we shake the room, yeah.
To make this life a wonderful adventure. By the promise of these things, brutes have risen to power. But they lie. They do not fulfill that promise. They never will. Dictators free themselves, but they enslave the people. Now let us fight to fulfill that promise. Let us all unite.
OTWTube.com, uncensored free speech platform.